Aloha and good morning, everyone. Welcome to the COVID Care Conversation here on the Facebook page of the Honolulu Star Advertiser. Good morning, I'm Yanji Denise.
And I'm Brian Kalesuji. Today is our first official talk show, if you will, here on Facebook on the platform of the Honolulu Star Advertiser. And really, this is an opportunity for you, the viewers, and for those of you tuning in here and readers of the Honolulu Star Advertiser to engage with us as we sort of enter this unprecedented time that we all find ourselves in with this coronavirus pandemic. I'm actually situated here in Oahu, on Oahu, while Yanji's actually all the way on the Big Island.
Yeah, I'm here. We came here to visit my mom for my daughter's spring break. She's three and my son is one. So we have had quite the time with the two little ones. We came here for spring break and now we are staying indefinitely. But thanks to this medium, we are allowed to talk to you. We're calling this the COVID Care Conversation. We're going to be here every morning, 10 o'clock. On this platform to really engage with you. We'd love to see if you're watching right now. So give us a like, let us know where you're watching from, and let us know what's on your mind. This platform, this show, if you will, is in partnership with the Hawaii Executive Collaboration. They're helping us bring you this conversation. HEC is a collective of Hawaii business leaders that are working to make Hawaii a better place. And we could really use that right now. And so that's why we're here.
Yeah, and really it's about, you know, I think when you look at AGC, it's this coming together of business leaders, and really that's what we're trying to do here as well. We're trying to bring the community together and using this platform to connect everyone throughout the islands, as well as those people who may be watching from abroad. We know that the Star Advertiser has a very far reach, and there are many people who are residents or were residents of Hawaii who now live on the mainland or overseas somewhere. That like to stay engaged and connected with what's happening here. So we'd love to also hear from you as well. If you're watching maybe from the mainland and want to provide us updates on what you're experiencing here. Again, this is not just something that's confined here to Hawaii or the United States, but this has become something that everyone is experiencing all over the world. Here specifically in Hawaii, this is a pretty significant day. Today is the first official day of Governor Ige's mandate for the entire state to sort of stay at home and work from home for those non-essential workers. So we're seeing really that mandate take into effect today and seeing it really on the streets with not a lot of people out there and really heeding those orders.
Yeah, we want to say good morning to you. Hello to Jason. Good morning. Let us know where you're watching from, what you're up to today. Are you part of that essential workforce or have you been deemed not essential and therefore you're working from home? Or perhaps you're one of the many people now who have been laid off or furloughed and you're watching this and trying to figure out what you do. We're going to have a whole show just on unemployment. And but that's not today. Today, of course, is just on that work order. What's cool about this platform, we want to show you a couple of things. So here we say hi to Chris Ortiz, who says, thank you for this. We're happy to see you here this morning, Chris. Jason, who says he works for Oahu Transit, has something, one of his concerns. He says, we can't practice social distancing and deny people if we have too many people on board. So we'd love to hear your concerns. And Jason, we'd love to hear from you. Is there a critical mass that happens on the bus at some point, or you know, whatever transit you're working on, whether it's the handyman or the bus, at some point do you tell people to take the next one, or how is that working? So please let us know. Good morning also to Kristen from Kaneohe. We love hearing from you. So the way the show is going to work is we're going to start out with some top headlines of the day. Ryan, why don't you bring us those, and then we're going to dive into the discussion.
Well, again, mentioning earlier that today, of course, is that first stay-at-home mandate. So this is sort of overlining for the entire state, right? We saw last week where the mayors for the city and county of Honolulu, Mayor Kirk Caldwell, as well as for Maui County, took this into effect. But now this sort of blankets the entire states and all the islands. Significantly for Hawaii Island, who really didn't have anything in place in terms of restrictions on what residents could and could not do. There was also not really restrictions on restaurants and establishments that were in place for the other islands. So this is probably having the most significant impact right now for Hawaii Island because of that drastic change in what they were used to doing leading up to this. So we'd love to hear from the people on Hawaii Island if there are people heeding this new statewide mandate. The other thing that we also saw that happened overnight was sort of a redacting or going back on a report that was listed from the State Department of Health that actually earlier had said that Hawaii saw its first death as a result of this COVID-19. They have since gone back and reviewed those tests to determine that it actually was not related. So the death toll related to this COVID-19 pandemic is now at zero for the state of Hawaii, but we are continuing to see significant increase in the overall number of people who have tested positive for coronavirus.
Yeah, and the Department of Health has been updating the state every day at noon. So those numbers are yesterday from noon. Of course, we do expect an increase today. We also want to let you know, I know a lot of people have been wondering, can I get tested? Should I get tested? What should I do? What are my symptoms? The Department of Health website, we really want to direct you there because they've been a great resource. They've got lots of information on testing, on contacting your primary care provider, what are the categories, how you can go about doing that. If that is too cumbersome or if it's too difficult, the amazing thing is that Aloha United Way is now using their hotline, that's just 211 on your phone, and they have volunteers there from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. that can actually answer those COVID questions. So that's really a great resource. I know that EMS is not really in a position right now. Some people have been calling 911. They don't want you to do that unless you are having a medical emergency, in which case, of course, call 911. But if you are concerned, you don't necessarily have a primary care doctor perhaps that you can call or you can't reach that person, 211 from Aloha United Way is a great place to sort of start that conversation if you don't want to muddle through a website.
Yeah, and going back to talking through that, and then that's important to note, you know, the EMS actually had a report yesterday. They made a release saying not to call because they are becoming overburdened and 911 is receiving a large influx of calls relating to testing questions. So that is a great resource at Aloha United Way. Another thing that I think is also significant to note, you know, in talking with a lot of the doctors that are on the front lines and doctors of the task force, they're basically saying the numbers that we're going to see here in Hawaii, that those who test positive will rise significantly this week. We're going to see a big surge. We've already seen it in the first 2 days this week. And of course, you have to think too, there was a large testing that happened in Kaka'ako on Saturday. A large amount of people went in for those testings as well. So they're trying to warn the public to say, hey, we expect these numbers to go up. Don't become so enthralled and scared. I mean, it is significant that those numbers are going up, but this is expected. The number two that's important to watch is those cases that are in the hospital, because there's a lot of those who are testing positive that are actually self-quarantined. But the number to really pay attention to is Department of Health is actually listing how many are hospitalized. And that's the number that I think is most significant, because the biggest concern in this is that the hospitals will become overrun and unable to accommodate just the mass number that we're seeing in a lot of other cities and states. So important to note that when you're looking at those numbers, they're expected to rise, but also make sure that you maybe pay more attention to the hospitalizations that are currently listed.
Yeah, that is great advice. We hear you. Some of the folks say the broadcast is cutting in and out, and we apologize for that. I am in Javi, so we have been having some trouble, but I'm looking at my Wi-Fi right now. It says we're full bars, so please bear with us as we have a few streaming issues. We understand that. We've got a great question here from Sam, who says, I'd like to know, do we just stay in the house and can't go outside and do your work? I think right now the whole purpose is to stay inside as much as possible. Now, obviously, the governor and the mayor have both talked about how important it is for your mental health and your physical health to go outside, take a walk, get a little fresh air, but also doing that and being mindful of social distancing. We've seen some scenes where people are, you know, crowding hiking trails or crowding beaches. They definitely don't want to do that. So perhaps it's just a walk around the block and then back inside. This is temporary. It's tough, but it is temporary.
Yeah, you know, we had reports. I saw actually a video that was posted of a large group of people playing soccer in Kapiolani Park yesterday. And that's certainly something that officials do not want to see happen. So we're asking everybody to sort of put those sort of activities on hold. The comment that I saw on Instagram was, if people in Italy can resist soccer for a little bit, we can do it here in Hawaii. Of course, Italy is suffering through a lot, but big soccer fans out there, in Italy. And of course, there's a lot of sacrifices that need to be made, but that's the type of things that they don't want to see. Another great resource and another great question I know that we have coming in are just exactly what parks are closed, what people are able to do. We all know that city parks are closed. So popular parks like Ala Moana Beach Park, Koko Head Park, those sorts of parks are essentially closed off. But the Honolulu Star Advertiser actually has a listing of some of those things that are open and closed that is a great resource to check out. But for the most part, city parks will remain closed during this time.
Yeah, and if you have a specific area that you're interested in looking at, Ryan's right. Mindy Pennybacker's article today really covers in depth what trails you can go on, what trails you can't. Sam wants to clarify, he wanted to know if he could do yard work. I think you can, Sam. I think yard work, as long as it's on your property and you're maintaining social distancing from your neighbors, which again is 6 feet away, I think then you're okay. And your yard probably, you know, when is it ever going to look better? You've got plenty of time if you're staying home to do that.
You can't use that as an excuse to not mow the lawn. Dad, I can't mow the lawn. Can't go outside. I think that's okay.
We know that the Star Advertiser every day has a big question, a poll that they do. It's informal. It's just based on readers who decide to answer that. Today's big question that they have is, how do you think President Trump is handling the coronavirus crisis? They've got four categories: very well, not well, pretty well, and trying is the last category. We'd love to hear what you think of that. So when this is over, head to the Star Advertiser's website and make sure to vote there. Our big question of the day, and we'll have one every day, is what are you doing that doesn't involve screens to stay busy? Now that, you know, 1201 is when this started and we're in it for the month, till the end of April, how are you keeping yourself grounded, sane, healthy, engaged, other than watching television and logging on with us?
Yeah, I mean, it's very interesting to see the different types of things that people are doing. One thing that has become more and more popular are sort of these online workouts. So the big craze last year was Peloton, the bike rides where people can actually engage with their instructors from afar. And now we're seeing that really across all platforms and all workouts. There's yoga instructors that are performing classes on Instagram Live. There's a lot of physical activities that are happening virtually now that are creating these online communities. So we want to know about that as well. Anything that you're doing that doesn't really involve a screen that's keeping you busy during this time.
Yeah, and I've seen a lot of people posting videos and pictures of the things they're baking. Everybody's hitting those ovens as they're stuck inside. We also want to use this platform to talk about how to help, how we can help each other, and we want to highlight some heroes in the community. We want to show you someone that Ryan and I both know from Hawaii VA Loans, Veteran Affairs Loans. That's Gabe Ame, and they have launched a website. We're showing it to you here. That's the homepage right there, ourkupuna.com, and that is a resource where people can get linked up. If you want to deliver groceries or medicine or supplies to a kupuna in need who has a hard time getting to the store, you can go to that website and sign up. On the other side, if you're someone who needs help, you can go to that website and sign up. Let me show you this. And this is some good news here. In just 24 hours since launching their site, they've already had 136 people sign up to help out some people in need. So they have a Instagram. They also have a website, ourkupuna.com.
Yeah, so we want to hear about the good things that are happening in the community. Yesterday, in sort of our preview, we highlighted a family that was actually making face shields for the frontline workers there at the hospital. So again, a lot of great things happening. I know right now it may seem difficult to sort of see the sun and sort of see beyond all these things that are happening here. Of course, there's a lot of important information and some pretty scary news that comes through, but there's also a lot of great things that are happening, especially right here at home. So we want to know about those things. If you know someone that's doing something good for the community and could use the support, this is a platform to really advertise that and to talk about that, and so that we can get that information out as well. We're seeing a lot of comments coming in. We thank you for that. We thank you for talking about it, and we have one right now.
Yeah, Giancarlo is saying, I'd like to know, what if your other half does essential work but doesn't know how to drive? Can you pick up and drop them off with the kids because you don't have a babysitter? Any advice on that? My understanding is that travel to and from work is allowed, and I would imagine that as long as you stay in the car and practice social distancing, if you're just going to your destination, dropping the person off, essentially being a taxi service for your other half, that would be permissible leaving the house. And then this is Julie. I like her, what she's saying. She's back to accepting the blessings of being a family again, back to basics. It's what we need right now.
Yeah, you know, I thought it was interesting to note there were some people who have experienced this in Italy, and there was actually a really well done piece that was done by Rob DeMillo on KHON. He actually did an interview with Stein von Tilburg, who is a former volleyball player here at the University of Hawaii, who was playing in Italy professionally, and talking to him about his situation out there and quarantining in Italy. Of course, we know that they have undergoing similar circumstances there as well, if not worse than what we're experiencing here in the United States. And Stein had an interesting tip. He said, for those people who are entering this phase, being a month in for them, he said, it's important to start to get a routine. Don't let your day sort of just kind of happen as they happen. Get up at the same time, work out, find a time to work out, find a time to do things with activities, with people, your kids maybe. Just try to build some sort of schedule and routine so that your days don't sort of just kind of blend in together and you really have more of a set routine. I thought that was great advice for people who are entering into this phase of a shutdown.
Yeah, I find that for myself too, because otherwise I sit there and just read article after article and it can be really overwhelming. And so connecting with family, one thing that I've been doing is actually calling people, which, I never used to do because you're so used to text and you're in such a hurry, but actually calling some friends that I haven't talked to for a while. We actually have time to talk on the phone again, if you can believe it. So that's been really nice. So I've enjoyed that very much. We like this. Maka says that she's working out, and the other thing that she's doing is, creating new projects. So we'd love to know what kind of projects those are, Maka. What kind of things are you doing? Are we talking about art? Are we talking about, I see some. So I'm checking us here too, so that I can see, and I see that the broadcast is a little bit interrupted. I'm hoping that that's just on my phone and not in real life. So forgive us with this platform. It seems like we're still broadcasting, but Ryan, do you want to check your side? Oh no, I think, yeah, we're still going.
Work on my side. The other thing that that we also mentioned today, or another interesting article in the Honolulu Star Advertiser today, is those restaurants that have sort of had to adjust with these times. Of course, with this new mandate of everyone staying in, restaurants, of course, have had to find ways with their dining rooms now closed. And so there is a big push to sort of find new ways to do takeouts, to find ways to support in this area as well. So we're seeing some of these restaurants be a little more creative with their takeout menus. And we want to support these restaurants and try to help them in any way possible. So really encourage those who are able to assist these restaurants in times of need. That would be a great way to kind of keep them going, because we know that they're also struggling with the shutdown that's happening.
Yeah, absolutely. Josh is telling us that he is checking his emails, doing yard work, Facebook Live, and drive-through Starbucks. Yeah, we still need our coffee, don't we? So if you can find a drive-through, I know a lot of people like to do that. One other thing we want to highlight, I know a lot of you want to know how to help. There we go. This is something that's been a shout out from the Lieutenant Governor, Josh Green. This is something that we grabbed from his Instagram. Starting on Friday, they are accepting donations of unused wrap PPE, that's personal protective equipment, like masks, N95 surgical masks. They're trying to grow the state's stockpile at the Healthcare Association of Hawaii. So they're going to have donation sites across the state, but starting on Friday is the first drop-off. To maintain social distancing, they're doing it right at the Capitol at that little roundabout in the by the Father Damien statue. They'll accept donations from 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. That is this Friday. So we want to just make sure that people know about that. It's a great way to help out. If you're one of the folks who happen to, stock up on some masks and now you feel like maybe they'd be better served at a hospital as opposed to in your closet, then this is a great place to drop them off. Also, they're asking the construction industry in particular, because a lot of those guys have these masks because they use them on work projects. If they can kokua and donate them, that would be very much appreciated.
And we're also seeing this happen not only here on Oahu, but the call out that is going out for the neighbor island. So Wilcox on Kauai has already put a call out for those same items. So has Maui Health on Maui, as well as the Hilo Medical Center over there on Hawaii Island. So really, if you're on the neighbor islands, there's still ways to give back. And this is something that is much needed. Again, right now, it's not like they're out of it, but they are preparing for this influx that they're going to see. Again, anytime that someone's coming in and getting tested, they want to make sure that they are protected. We're hearing reports already here in Hawaii that a lot of these nurses and these frontline workers are actually reusing some of their gear, which is, of course, not recommended. They want to be able to make sure that they're using fresh gear that hasn't been contaminated, that hasn't been exposed. So if you do have those masks available, again, we want to encourage you to find the hospital that's maybe closest to you or drop it off at the state capitol again on Friday. We're also hearing reports of local designers that are getting into the fight as well, and they are actually custom making these face masks for the various health professionals as well. So great to see that.
Yeah, and Audrey's saying aloha from Kailua this morning. So aloha to you, Audrey. Ruth has a question that I think answers itself, which is, how do you ask a question? Do you type it in the comments? Why, yes, Ruth, that is exactly how you do it. You know, we're all learning this together. I know some of you are experiencing some broadcast interruptions, and we do apologize for that. We are still working this out, but we're going to be here every day, 10 o'clock in the morning, to talk to you, to try to answer questions that you might have, and also to just build community, to let you know about the resources that are out there, let you know what things people are doing in the community to help out, because we also want to uplift each other with things like the good news that we just shared about local designers. I know Jana Lam, Ari South, and Ann Namba were three that I saw that are out there that are sewing masks for the first responders. Now, what I have understand at the moment is that they're really trying to build the stockpile, that they were not experiencing the critical shortages of a place like New York City, but they want to build that so that we don't get to that point.
Yeah, and just going back to sort of the broadcast as well, we are, just so you know, we are seeing a lot of these interruptions on various social media platforms. We saw it yesterday on Instagram for a little bit, as well as Facebook. And that's because when you think about it now, there's a lot of people that are now relying on the internet to communicate. And so the bandwidth overall has to be increased because of the amount of influx of people that are now going online to do things like this to stay connected. So I know that our local providers and servers have been working to increase sort of the capacity of the network to allow these sorts of things to happen. So it is unfortunately an occurrence that is happening more and more we're seeing because of the growth of this. So we ask you to just bear with us here. It's a network overload, but we're trying our best to find ways where we can keep you engaged and informed.
And Lorianne says, we love you here in Eva Beach. We love you too. And I think that is mahalo, and that there's a little autocorrect there. But I like my hollow too. So we really do appreciate you writing in, letting us know where you're writing from. I think, you know, the reason that we wanted to launch this really is to have a place where people in Hawaii can really communicate and talk to each other. We appreciate all of our counterparts in traditional broadcast mediums. But this is a place where you can actually talk back and forth. You know, we're watching the news too, but this is a place where you can actually interact and talk to us. So we love to hear from you. And I like this one from Frank. This is a great idea. Computer work from home tips, set an alarm on your phone to go off every half hour and get up, stretch and move around. I don't know if I could do it every half hour. That might interrupt my flow a little too much, but I think that is important because you get stuck here. Whereas if you work in an office or in a group setting, you naturally tend to get up, go talk to a friend, go talk to a coworker or colleague, if you will. If you're at home, it is very easy to just get glued to your chair.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. Important to get out and get active. We also have one from Julie, who's saying to also please remember Kopiolani Hospital. Of course, you know, they provide such important care for our Keiki in the community and do a wonderful job of that. They are also in need, maybe not necessarily ones that are dealing with that influx of patients related to this as part of the network of Hawaii Pacific Health, but they are also providing really a great care for those children and those keiki who may have those autoimmune diseases and respiratory illnesses as well. So great to hear them, and we want to make sure that we mahalo them and thank them for the work that they're doing as well.
Yeah, I mean, what a tough time just to be, you know, if you're a family with a child that has an illness and is in an immunocompromised position, or, you know, if you're someone who just had a baby. I know that some of our friends recently just had a baby, and, you know, it's a joyous time, but it's also, you know, that just adds to your uncertainty. So we want to make sure that we are caring for all of those healthcare workers who are caring for our community. So thank you so much. This is an interesting question. Do you know if the donation centers like the Goodwill are taking donations? My understanding is that Goodwill has stopped accepting donations. We'll work on this a little bit more and try to get some answers. I know that just because of sanitation concerns that they've stopped taking regular household items. There, of course, is a need for personal protective equipment and things like that, but that they're asking for new unused masks, gloves, but regular donations, my understanding is not. But if you are in the mood to donate, another thing that you can donate is food. I know the food banks on all of the islands have been saying that their shelves have been wiped clean. Maui Food Bank, here in on Oahu, the Honolulu Food Bank also really could use your help. So if you stockpiled maybe a little bit too much, maybe it's time to share with some of our neighbors.
Yeah, but we'll try to get exact confirmation on that. We'll reach out to those nonprofits to find out about those donations to really make sure that we are giving you the accurate information and maybe see what advice they may have if you have goods that you would like to donate to Goodwill, to the Salvation Army. I have a few contacts there, so I'll make sure to contact them. And that's one of the things. So for Nancy, please tune in tomorrow. We'll have the answer for you. If we're unable to find those answers for you, we will certainly work on that and provide you with an update tomorrow. So those are one of the things that we'll put on our to-do list to follow up on. So if you have questions like that about donations or anything, please make sure that you ask us and we can try to get those answers for you.
I love this from Richard, who said that he's happy to donate time and his truck to donate emergency medical supplies. Well, head to ourkupuna.com. That's a great place to start, you know, because there are not necessarily emergency medical supplies, but even just getting a kupuna, a bottle of prescription medication could make all the difference. So that's a great place for you to go, Richard. And thank you so much. If you can see in the comments, Ryan, you can't see because it's cut off here, but this person is even including their phone number. So yeah. You've got a direct request for Richard. Please contact him. So this is about, this is sort of on the where we start to wrap up. One other way that you can help in a very big way is to contribute to the Hawaii Community Foundation's Resiliency Fund.
Yeah, that's a great way where the community has really come together. Of course, Hawaii Community Foundation, an organization that has a lot of partners, provide support throughout the years to a number of nonprofits, partnering with the Omidyar family and really launching this effort to sort of gather funds and resources to provide grants and opportunities to help support the community during this time. And because a lot of people rely on Hawaii Community Foundation, a lot of the nonprofits, they're going to be turning to them for help. So if you're looking for a way to give, make a donation, we encourage you to head over to the Hawaii Community Foundation's page and click on there. You actually have a banner at the top that has a link directly to how you can help the Resiliency Fund. There's also some other things that are happening. We're also actually launching a website as well that will help to engage you. That's coming up in a little bit as well. We hope to have that posted and up running by the end of this week. But of course, a great resource is the Honolulu Star Advertiser as well. On the homepage, there's actually a pink banner that runs across the top that sort of archives all of the articles that are related to the corona pandemic. So if you have questions or if there was an article or you need to reference something, just head on back there to really reference some of the things that have done. They have a great job in listing of all the closures as well. So important to note that. And of course, tomorrow is another big day with another important milestone, I guess, if you will, that will be happening that we'll focus on a little bit tomorrow as well.
Yeah, and that, of course, is the travel advisory that anyone coming into the state has to self-quarantine for 14 days. That is Governor Ige's order. And that also has helped to bring the flights coming in and out of Hawaii to a grinding halt. So we're going to be talking a lot about that tomorrow. We want to hear from you. Leave a comment, share this on your page, get the word out that this is happening every morning, 10 o'clock right here. We are going to go back and work on some of our technical issues so that we don't have that issue again. You know, this is a work in progress, and we really mahalo you for being here with us. We want to build community. We want to help uplift things. We know that you're dealing with so much, so we want to be here for you, and we want you to be here for each other. So with that, we'll leave you for now. Mahalo for joining us. I'm Yanji Denise.
I'm Michael Esiju. We'll see you here tomorrow at 10 a.m.